How to virtually participate in Launch America, Vice President Pence highlights the nation's return to human spaceflight, and honoring a legendary astronomer. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On May 20th, astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley arrived at our Kennedy Space Center in Florida ahead of their launch on NASA's SpaceX Demo 2 test flight to the International Space Station. 2 days later, the mission got the formal go-ahead for May 27th launch attempt at a flight readiness review. The mission, targeted for launch from Kennedy's historic Launch Complex 39A, is being celebrated as Launch America, marking the first human spaceflight from the U.S. since the end of the space shuttle era.
I happen to have been one of the four astronauts that landed here almost 9 years ago in T-38s on the 4th of July of 2011 to close out the space shuttle program. So it's incredibly humbling to be here to start out the next launch from the United States.
As graduates of military test pilot schools, if you gave us one thing that we could have put on our list of dream jobs that we would have gotten to have someday, it would have been to be aboard a new spacecraft, be conducting a test mission aboard that spacecraft, and Doug and I get that chance to do it. So we're thankful for that opportunity.
While pre-launch and launch day activities are not open to the public due to social distancing concerns, NASA invites you to virtually participate in this historic milestone. In addition to continuous launch day to docking day coverage on NASA television, virtual activities include a NASA social as well as activities across our social media channels, including YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. For more about how to virtually participate, go to nasa.gov/beourguest.
Welcome to the Launch America edition of the National Space Council.
On May 19th, Vice President Mike Pence convened the 7th meeting of the National Space Council at our headquarters in Washington, D.C. Our Administrator Jim Bridenstine, as well as astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley, joined the event via live web streams to highlight NASA's SpaceX Demo 2 mission to the space station. On May 20th, we announced that the Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope currently under development has been named in honor of the late Nancy Grace Roman, NASA's first chief astronomer. The telescope is targeted for launch in the mid-2020s to investigate long-standing astronomical mysteries and to search for distant planets beyond our solar system. NASA received 4 2020 Webby Awards and 4 People's Voice Awards highlighting the agency's diverse online offerings. We received an agency record 12 nominations this year. The Webby Awards are presented by the International Academy of Digital Arts and Sciences. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries launched an unpiloted HTV-9 cargo spacecraft on May 20th, loaded with more than 4 tons of supplies for the International Space Station, including the final set of new lithium-ion batteries and adapter plates to complete a multi-year upgrade of the station's power system. Annie Glenn, wife of late NASA astronaut and U.S. Senator John Glenn, died this week at age 100. A NASA statement praised Annie Glenn as a stalwart member of the space and military communities whose courageous support of her legendary husband was unmatched. The statement also noted her lifelong public service on behalf of children, the elderly, and the disabled. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.